a little bit on correspondence. We put forth the consent agenda last week. I'm going to go over the things that right now are a non-issue. Number four has been sent. I think I got that out to everyone, the response on the insurance.
In color.
And I understand, and Fred, you can yell at me from the background there, that last night the selectmen okayed, let's see, 3, 4, and 6 for that information to come to us?
That's right.
Okay, and we will see that by Friday, by Thursday?
Tell you that. We're right in the middle of getting the audit finished. We're in the middle of a whole bunch of stuff, including warrant articles and month-end appropriations, and we'll get to you as soon as we can.
Can you give me a little bit more concise time frame for that, Fred?
Assessing's coming from the assessor, not from us.
Right. Okay.
He doesn't report to me. I have no control over him.
All right. Then I'll take that one off your list, and I'll contact him directly.
The selectmen have asked him to do that as soon as he can.
I appreciate that. And the other questions coming from you?
The IT subcommittee? Is that one of those?
From you, I guess the contracted services, number 3, is coming from the assessor.
Yes.
Number 4 has been answered. Number 5, I think, is very important based on the warrant articles, and that has to do with the undesignated fund balance.
Well, we'll inquire the auditor. I can't give you an exact figure. I can give you a figure of $4,500,000, but that's not exact.
And that is on hand. That's the cash balance.
That's correct. That's the amount of surplus.
Cash?
Cash.
There's no such thing as cash
or anticipated.
Is it a liquid asset?
It's an asset.
Is it liquid?
Depends on how you look at liquid.
Oh, okay. Let's stop.
Defined by generally accepted accounting practices.
No. There's no such thing as cash in municipal government.
The liquid asset is defined by general accounting principles.
Yeah, well, the problem is that the legislature makes the accounting principles for municipal governments, not general accounting systems. So when you look at the amount of money that we have outstanding, which averages somewhere around $1.7 million in unpaid taxes, where our money comes from, that's certainly not what I would call liquid. But it is an asset, and the auditors do book it.
So when do you think the auditors will be getting to the point where they can tell us what we really have, Fred?
Well, you'll have to ask the auditors. I don't speak for them. They don't speak for me.
I mean, this is December, and I think it's almost 11-plus months now since we ended the year, and the auditors usually get finished in the spring. Here we are at the end of the year. I mean, and we'll need those exact figures to do warrant articles that dip into the undesignated fund. So keep that in mind. I won't approve or even look at ones that have dip into undesignated without knowing those numbers, Fred.
Well, I can only tell you we'll have the numbers when the auditors report them and actual figures.
Well, somebody
ought to
line
it should be relatively soon.
When are the auditors due to be in? Are they scheduled to come in, Fred?
They're going to come before the board as soon as we receive the audit. Then they will be coming to the Board of Selectmen to make a presentation.
So they have
hopefully before the end of this year.
I'm sorry?
Hopefully within the next couple of weeks. They were hopefully finishing up the audit yesterday.
So they were finishing up the audit yesterday, and they have to put that together and get it to the board.
So they can review it before they come.
And then be scheduled to come in?
Yes.
This could create an impact on warrant articles, as Mike said, that are looking to be funded from those amounts. And I'm going to move on from that. That leaves 1 and 6. I'll knock out 6 first. I did speak to Ellen Lavin, town treasurer, and she had already made plans for this evening. She offered to come in on the 10th. But I suggest to all of you for discussion, if it's necessary to actually bring her in or to send her written questions, that we will go over that night. So,
I think our schedule is too tight going forward. We could have accommodated her this evening, I think, but most of our schedule is pretty tight. In fact, I think we might need to add an additional meeting or two sometime in January. So the only alternative is to generate questions. I would suggest that I could centralize some questions. So if anyone has any, send them to me. I'll formulate some questions on my own as well. Present them to Thursday night's meeting for your approval to send to the treasurer. Does that make sense?
My only fear with that is that the only written correspondence that we've gotten from her so far has created a lot.
Asking her to come in.
It created a lot more questions. Mm-hmm. And it would be easier if she was available. I mean, I definitely see the benefit of having her, presenting her with a list of questions, mm-hmm. and then maybe having her come in and explain those answers.
Right. I think once we get the answers, we can decide whether we need further explanation.
Yeah, I mean,
if we could do, you know, sometime late January or something like that.
Yeah, I mean, I definitely see if we need to add something in there to do that. I mean, it's worth it.
So just send me the questions, hopefully by tomorrow night, and I'll have them prepared Thursday for Thursday night's meeting for you guys to mash it up or otherwise approve it. And then we'll send it on through the chairman to the treasurer. And that way we don't have to schedule her unless we find more ambiguity in her answers.
I'm okay with that.
Anyone not okay with it? Want to talk to the neighbor? All right, so we go.
Okay. I have an issue. We have made a point on this board that everything goes through the chairman.
What does that have to do with the conversation?
It has to do with the fact that, and I'm not, this is nothing against Mr. Jones, but.
So you would feel better if all the questions were sent directly to me?
Yes.
Okay. I don't have a problem with that. All
it's
right.
Just been our policy.
So you want to lead that way, send them out in written form, and go over them for Thursday.
And bring them for the meeting Thursday night. We'll beat them to death.
Yeah. All right. That was as soon as she could be available to come in. So not wanting to waste her time and realizing we're in a little bit of a time crunch ourselves, we'll do that. Okay. And then the last one, going backwards, actually, was number one on the consent agenda, where last night, Fred, I believe you and the Board of Selectmen took exception with a visit to DPW by Mike and by Jerry for some fact-finding. Correct?
Yeah, this budget committee. The budget committee is not an operational board.
Mm-hmm.
The selectmen are.
Okay.
Anything that's not operational will provide. Anything that's operational is outside your purview.
Okay.
By statute.
So if that question, let me ask you this. If that question was reworded, removing operational.
Give it a try.
Madam Chair.
Reword it, send it to us.
Madam Chair.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what statute he's referring to.
If you don't, then you shouldn't be on this committee because it's your statute.
All right, my statute is 32:16, duties and authorities of the budget committee, Roman numeral 2.
Your job, according to that statute, is to review the budget prepared by the Board of Selectmen.
Excuse me, Fred. Go ahead, Tim.
Under Roman numeral 2, it says our duty is to confer with the governing body or bodies and with other officers, department heads, and other officials relative to estimated costs, revenues anticipated, and services performed to the extent deemed necessary by the budget committee. Operational procedures are, in fact, services performed.
Well, your definition is not the town council's
definition. And so there it is, right in RSA 32, duties and authority of the budget committee. the last sentence of this says, it shall be the duty of all such offices and other persons to furnish such pertinent information to the Budget Committee. So yes, I do know the statute that we operate under, and it clearly says services performed to the extent deemed necessary by the Budget Committee. Now, the Budget Committee decided that the extent that we need to evaluate the services performed include operating procedures, then that is what it is.
Well, that's out of order.
Jim, I'm going to... Scott?
I don't think we're going to resolve anything here. We're going to get in a shouting contest. I think we ought to move on.
I'm sorry, I have a bad throat, so I have to really throw it out there so I can be heard.
Madam Chairman, my suggestion is that this Budget Committee get an educational course in the entire statute, not in one half of a paragraph.
Actually, we did.
Okay. Gentlemen.
Too bad you didn't pay attention.
I did. I got it on recording. I watched
all
it multiple
right.
times.
Everybody's out of order unless you want...
Like to throw objects around, or RSAs around, as though they were candy. Thank you for the candy, Mr. Bean.
You're welcome.
All right. Gentlemen. I'm going to take the floor, okay? Or we'll see an early adjournment to this meeting. Purpose of the fact-finding is to help these departments in this town prepare a budget, to listen to what they need, in some cases see what they need, those of us at times who don't get to every nook and cranny around. And decide as we are charged to make a reasonable budget. It is not to interfere with the operations, and I would say that was not the intent, Fred, was to interfere with operations.
We would hope not, Madam Chairman, but after reading the chairman of your delegation's letter to the town, there was no question in our mind that, in fact, all the operations were going to be reviewed in detail.
Well, no, I would sit here and say that is to the negative. That was not the intent.
Intent
what we are looking at is $5 million worth of warrant articles for DPW. That's a lot of money where our budget is concerned. And whether it's in the form of a warrant article or in the form of a budget, it's a lot of money. There's a lot of needs on the table. And the two gentlemen sitting at this table that were put out there as the delegates, not as a subcommittee, but as delegates for the Budget Committee, are perhaps of those here the most qualified, having both been former selectmen. I know Jerry spent a lot of time at DPW during his tenure, and Mike has spent his entire life in one way or another. So we weren't just sending anyone haphazardly. I think our intent needs to be made very clear. We're not looking to interfere. We're looking to send qualified people to have an open discussion and just review the needs. Not sit there and tell you how to operate DPW, but the needs for the things that money is being requested for from the taxpayers, so that when we come back and we recommend or not recommend these warrant articles, they're done from a factual standpoint, not from an emotional standpoint, and definitely not from a void, which is what we seem to have from an informational gathering standpoint. So I would say this was done in the most uncontentious way and not to be made into a battle zone. That's our intent. Now, if one word in there, operational, threw this whole thing south, I apologize for that. I can rewrite that and take that word out. The intent is to discuss what is going to go on the warrant articles, what is needed from the standpoint of money only.
My suggestion, Madam Chair, is that you do that, that you rewrite that. May I respectfully remind the Chair?
Yes, sir.
That unless you appoint a subcommittee, the only way anyone on this board can in fact do what you're suggesting is if the board calls a legally posted meeting and a majority of the board goes. You may appoint subcommittees under the statute, and they have the right to represent you. Delegates do not have a right to represent you under the statute because they have to conduct minutes and prepare minutes, which nobody has ever seen from the subcommittees. But the statute's very specific. You can have committees. And anyone, any board and committee that's elected, appointed, or whatever can do that. They have to keep minutes. Anything other than committees or subcommittees, you have to have the entire board present. I suggest you re-review the statute in that regard.
We will revisit this conversation later on in the evening, as we have our police chief here to give us his budget. Thank you, Fred.
Madam Chair.
I'm moving on, Tim. We'll discuss it more later. I have, looking at calendar and what's left on the municipal calendar, I have scheduled another session in January for warrant articles. So we'll have our review and we'll have two sessions for warrant articles. Unfortunately, they'll all be in the same week. The new date that was added is January 8th. It is on a Friday. Cable is going to try to accommodate us with a broadcast on that, we're hoping.
Madam Chair, I think we need more than one more additional.
Thanks, Chief.
Thank you.
Well,
couple.
I would say that there's only so much we can do with the calendar, Michael. At this point, I think we've done enough budget review with the department that everybody should be starting to prepare their own Excel spreadsheet for the review. And we need to tighten up a little bit more how we approach things. I think tonight we probably could have condensed a little bit by an hour. And not that we should race through things. This is a multi-million-dollar budget, and we want to give it its due. And we have two more departments coming in that equally will be as long. But when it comes to the review itself, and when it comes to the warrant articles, I don't know that we need as lengthy a discussion, one for one. It's, somebody once said, try to say it in 20 words or less, and I know I'm guilty of not being able to do that, but when we start thinking about review, when we start thinking about the volume of warrant articles that will come before us, and this is nothing new. I mean, I know we're talking about a lot of warrant articles. Some of us have been here before. We got through it in one session, never mind three. So I think if everyone comes prepared and doesn't ramble on, and we'll give some consideration to the other two sessions that week, starting at 6 o'clock if we need to.
So you're going to have the final budget review after we do the warrant articles?
Yeah, we'll do the warrant articles first. So right now the positions, all I want you to take out of this tonight mm-hmm. is that we have the 8th on a Friday night booked, January 8th.
I got it.
Okay, and we still have time after that if we need it in the following week, but I'd like to have two solid nights of warrant articles and then the budget review if we wrap the warrant articles up earlier. Then we can start the budget review. But don't save your preparation until then. Okay. Start your notes now and make them as concise as you can be. That way you should be able to, with the warrant articles, we'll be approving or recommending or not recommending, which makes that easy enough. With the budget, the way we've done it this year, we made it a little bit more difficult for ourselves because we haven't made any motions as we've gone along. But that doesn't mean you don't come in department by department with your motions ready to go mm-hmm. and a quick vote. We've discussed it to death. So when somebody throws something out there at a point, a dollar value, there shouldn't be a whole lot of discussion on it at that point. It should be yay and nay or an amendment to the dollar amount, and we'll come out with a conclusion at the bottom. So just a forecast of things to come. I've listened to everybody with the need to put another session in, and we have it. And hopefully, like I say, we'll be accommodated with cable, so we'll be broadcast. If not, I'll be crying, but see what happens from there.
We're going to need the undesignated fund balance as well so that we don't start approving warrant articles with have money in them taken out of the undesignated fund balance and we fall below the safety.
Well, obviously, we're about as transparent as a group can get. And all I can tell you, Jerry, is we've asked 15 ways to Sunday. We've asked it yet again tonight. I mean, there is money in the count.
Yep.
All right. And That's what we're asking. How much money is in that account right now? We don't want the anticipated amount to come in. And yes, that is the anticipated amount is also considered an asset. But we've been asking all along for the cash amount. And it's not to grill anybody. It's so that we can make a decision on the warrant articles that they want to have funded from these funds.
Yep.
So
it appears we're not going to get an answer to that.
Well,
because cash doesn't exist, as you listen to
Tom. You know, we don't have
really
an answer
tonight.
Today, and we're not there yet.
He's refused based on the basis that cash doesn't exist.
I'm going to take this approach in my mind, and everybody in here is always free to vote their conscience. From where I sit right now, I'm not reviewing the warrant articles. At some point, I will be.
Mm-hmm.
If I do not have enough information, I will vote as I have in the past. And unfortunately, it may be a good warrant article that I would have supported, but if I don't have all the information, and some of you have sat here with me and heard this before, where there were good things out there, but we didn't have enough.
If I don't have the information,
you can't go
can't
there.
Be
the problem comes is that if we don't have a reasonable picture of our actual financial status, then we cannot put the budget in context to our financial status because we don't have it. And none of the other warrant articles, whether they're dipping into the so-called surplus or not. It's the same issue that constantly confuses me, how the Board of Selectmen can generate a proposed budget to us without having any clue what the existing fund balances are and the myriad of funds that exist. They ask for money that's, you know, readily spendable in already existing funds, but they don't even know it's there.
Well, this is our job. I would say focus in on the trust funds, focus in on all the
Well, yes, that's
auxiliary
why I'm pointing out
the
importance of us getting a as close of a reasonable financial accurate picture as we can.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, the statement that that I heard tonight would suggest that when it comes to the so-called undesignated fund balance, what most people refer to as a surplus, is not going to be forthcoming. The key is there are really two components in there, as I understand it. You got taxes that have not yet been paid but have been billed. Those are, you know, receivables.
So they're anticipated.
Yeah, so are they lumping that together with what I and everyone else in the world would think of as cash?
Right.
And but, you know, you heard the confusion earlier tonight, which was engendered for reasons I cannot fathom.
Oh, that was a deliberate diversion.
Yeah.
But I want to make a comment, if I may, about that.
Yeah.
At the audit of the end of 13, there was $2.1 million in cash. I don't care what you call it. It's cash. On hand, not receivable. Since then, since that audit was finished for 13, we spent $1 million last year to keep the taxes down. We spent $500,000 this year to keep the taxes down. We spent $600,000 for NextEra. That adds up to the 2.1, and I don't remember any chunks of money going into that fund
to
keep it back up again. So I think we have a serious problem right now with a lack of knowledge. Only we don't know what's going on. We can only base it on what we had for facts at the last time we had the factual information. We can only assume it's damn close to zero.
Well,
it's a serious question that may, in fact,
it's
reflect
a
serious
question.
Problem.
We don't have the answers for
it. We gotta get the facts.
We've asked.
But that means we can't support
the fact that
one article,
we don't have the warrant articles yet.
The
here.
Fact that the audit is not complete
yeah.
leaves us right now in thin air. The audit is about to be wrapped up, so I know it's been trying on everybody's patience and pushing us our schedule and things we need to do. So I would say plan yourself accordingly with the budget, with a plan A and a plan B. You know, best I can tell you right now, but those numbers do have to come. That audit has to come. We don't see that audit pretty soon. This
variations of attempts to not disclose what is should be readily disclosable.
Well, you also don't have the default budget.
Kind of suggests that the transparency that I was certainly looking forward to in this year's process is not there, and it's very disappointing.
We don't have the default budget, right?
You don't have the default budget, and I have had great difficulty getting people to put things in writing. They give me a lot of advice mm-hmm. verbally, and I think I have spoken to just about anybody who's anybody in the state to today, I spent quite a bit of time on the phone with Judy Silva, who many of us respect up at NHMA, but therein too lies the conflict.
Yep.
Because she represents the town.
Mm-hmm. The selectmen specifically.
And the selectmen specifically. But I've had a great working relationship with Judy and going to her with questions through the years.
But there are things that we can rely upon, Madam Chair, and that is our own capacity to read. Simple words. You heard earlier tonight that you can't have a representative to the budget committee. It has to be a subcommittee. All right. Referencing RSA 32, which is the budget law, which is what gives rise to a budget committee. Yet if you search RSA 32, you will find zero reference to a term subcommittee. Subcommittee does not exist in RSA 32. Mm-hmm. So why are we being forced to create one?
Well,
why don't we finish on this point? But it does make reference to something very noteworthy. And it says, right after it says that the members shall elect from the members at large a chairman, the next sentence says, the committee may elect other officers as it sees fit. Period.
Well,
there is no qualifier to that. So if we decide, which we did in one of those consent item agendas, we decided to create an officer called a representative. That is a legitimate position created by law by the subcommittee. There is no requirement in the subcommittee as to, for this budget committee to create any subcommittees. The word subcommittee doesn't even appear in RSA 32. The only appearance it does exist in terms of what we can create is in that line. The committee may elect other officers as it sees fit. That's the only appearance of 32.
I believe that has to do with inside the budget
committee. Maybe like treasurer, secretary.
That's right, inside the budget committee. And we have officers and we're asking them to go do a duty for us.
At a point in fact, as Nick, you serve.
Just like we asked the chairman to go do duty and go ask so-and-so for information and whatnot. She's acting outside of the committee, but as an officer of the committee. We're doing the same thing with the creation of a representative. Asking them as an officer of this committee in term of a representative to get us information. The same. Function.
Talking two different
no, we're not. We're talking the same paragraph of the same RSA.
I'll illustrate that along the same lines that Tim's talking about, but in a less contentious arena. We appointed you as the representative to CIP, and we appointed Nick as representative to Recreation Committee.
Good point.
All right. That speaks to that, but it's in, again, a different environment, so you look at it different than when someone is trying to make it look like we're rocking the boat. We're, again, the intention was to do no harm. It was to fact find so that we could reasonably determine if we should recommend these expenses to the taxpayers or not.
Right.
And again, if we're going to work in a vacuum, it really hurts them more than it helps them. And I'll rest on that note tonight. If it's all right with the committee, I'm going to change the wording to the request a little bit and see what I get for a response.
Go right ahead.
I'm afraid
that... What are you going to...
Consensus on that?
What are you going to request for me?
I watched last night and what they took exception with, and even Selectman Bean said it at the end. What is statute is statute. And it seemed the Achilles heel in number one was the use of... saying operational procedures. Well, operational procedures, and we know what we're talking about. We're not looking to go in and undo their operations or tell them how to operate anything at DPW. But the use of the word operations became the Achilles heel that turned the board against voting for that, but they did vote on approving the information coming to us on the other articles. So what I'm saying is if one word upset all that,
reword.
I can go back, reword it,
reword
and try it.
Go ahead.
And I'm not telling you I'm going to get any better response.
What do you got for an
what
idea?
Have I got to lose?
Take the word out
on that operation
all right.
last night.
But that wasn't, I was trying to explain tonight before Fred got upset, that that's not our intent. And by now, everybody should understand what our intent is. I'm very proud
what
of this.
What is
committee.
The intent? What is the intent of going down to Public Works?
Information.
Well, can't they, when they come, I mean, do we do that? Did we do that to the police department? Did we do that to the fire department? Have we done that? Have we gone to the fire?
We did that for the IT committee. We've done it, we did it for the schools when you were there, so please.
I know.
No, that is a wonderful point that Mike brings up, though.
What are we trying to glean out of Public Works or any other department that they cannot come and sit here and give us the information?
I think the magnitude is that they're asking for $5 million in warrant articles.
But that means we can't offer up questions?
Different areas.
No, Nick, but what it means is that if they want to buy a fleet of new trucks, and if Mike goes down there, I remember last year they wanted to buy a couple of new trucks, remember? And then Mike Plouffe said, this is ridiculous, okay? And so perhaps if he wants, if they want to replace a truck, maybe Mike would like to go and look at it.
They're asking for the same three they asked for last year.
Okay, so.
I just really think we are out of our realm as a budget committee to be going down to Public Works or any other department, and, I'm sorry, Mike, crawling underneath the truck.
We're not suggesting that.
That was done, sorry, but it was. A couple of years ago, I was on the budget committee. I just think, are we overstepping our bounds as a budget committee?
Well, as an answer to that.
To be going down to departments and looking at automobiles, looking at trucks. Certainly, there are items down there. There are big, big items that you need a housing area to go in and wash down those trucks, especially after they've been out softening the roads. The town constantly turns that down.
Now they've moved that up to a $2 million warrant article.
Are we overstepping our bounds as a budget committee?
I don't think so.
By going down and checking on.
I think you have an excellent point.
I'm sorry. We're the budget committee. We make the budget. We're going to approve the budget. We're going to do our warrant articles.
Okay, so you're saying they don't belong down there?
I just absolutely don't think we should be micromanaging the departments. That's what we pay big bucks for these guys to do.
I agree. If they're gonna,
I'm sorry.
If we have specific questions that we can ask, we should put them in writing. If they don't want to answer those questions and they're going to come here and say, I want three new trucks, well, then you better bring plenty of proof in pictures or whatever. I mean, the town clerk came up here and said, the reason I want to increase my budget for my part-time staff, this is the paperwork. It's in Appendix G of our book. She had a picture of all the files that didn't get filed this year. And that's a powerful statement, as a picture of all the work that hasn't gotten done. If you get three trucks that are in that bad of disrepair, bring us evidence of your trucks that are in disrepair so that we can make a better informed decision.
All right, well, you know what? Rather than belabor this, can I have a motion?
Excuse me, I have
all right, well, me. Go ahead.
Thank you, Ben, coming too.
Mike had his up too.
As I think many of you remember, I did not agree in the spring when these committees were created because I didn't think it would be productive. But nonetheless, the committees were created, and since the budget committee created the committees, I want to do all I can to encourage their work. In fact, I even got stuck on one.
Which one was that?
That doesn't change my point of view that the subcommittees was not going to be a productive way for us to do our work. I still believe that, although I have tried to be productive as a committee member on a subcommittee. There have been challenges with the DPW. The DPW committee was created because it was perceived, and I agree with his perception, that we have at least one, probably two, members that have a degree of expertise in that area, and that they could educate us from a budget committee perspective in a way that we could not get educated from simply having an interchange with the DPW director. Right? So the budget committee took that position. Having taken that position, the DPW subcommittee was basically dysfunctional. And
toss this out.
That's my opinion. It was basically dysfunctional. And as a consequence, there became a kind of a row that was developing, and as a way of quelling that row, the concept of creating an officer called a representative, so that we didn't have to go through this subcommittee stuff. We could just directly, under RSA 32:16, using the law of what our duties and authority of the budget committee is to say, you representative, you go directly to the department head, which the law allows us to do, and that's what we did. And what happened was, we got a reaction from the town manager last night that, oh, no, you can't do that. I mean, it's clearly spelled out in RSA 32.
Roman numeral 2 spells it out.
That we do have that authority. And so now, for me, I'm long past the question of whether we should have subcommittees, because I still don't think we should. I'm long past the question of whether we should have a DPW question, because the Budget Committee already said we need one. So I'm going to support it, even though I don't agree with it. I am long past all of the questions about whether or not we can ask the right questions and get the knowledge we seek.
Let me toss this out.
I'm not done. But I am at this point. We are not slaves or subordinates to the town manager or to the Board of Selectmen. We are a separately elected body. And if we cannot stand up for ourselves, then we fall down quite definitely all over the place. We have to stand up for what is our authority and our duty. It's absolutely necessary that we uphold our duty, and to have other people tell us what we can and cannot do when the law clearly says we have the duty to do so. I say it's a matter of our own integrity as a Budget Committee. We either hang together or we will surely hang separately.
Yeah. Thank you, Tim.
Wow.
Sunny.
Yeah. I think what's missing from this is the town manager can say what he interprets the way he wants to. We can interpret it the
I'm
way
I'm not interpreting, I'm
until
reading.
Until you get a legal ruling on an RSA.
Oh, wait, we got a break.
On the intent of the RSA in the court.
Okay.
You will fight
it. I'm going to throw this out. We could go around the table with this another 20 times. I think we've got two choices here. One,
adjourn.
To leave. No, that's choice number 3.
Oh.
The first one is that we revise the question, send it back, and see if we get something else on that. The second one is that we forget about all of it.
No reword.
All right, I will
and
move.
No, wait a minute.
I will move that you change operational procedures
Tim,
to
finish.
Services what? Performed as specified in the law.
I'll
Hold
second that.
Go ahead and finish your remarks.
Yeah, let me finish what I have to say first. Thank you. Appreciate that. And the second one is that we at this point, we're so late into this that we forget about the visit DPW. I think both of you should probably have it encapsulated in your brain anyway and move on. But I would tell you that I would expect that DPW session to be lengthy, and there's a lot in DPW.
Well, they got a new one last night with the $1.8 million bond article.
Yeah.
Which I know very little about.
Interpretation.
I mean, there's four parts to it, and it was a big PowerPoint presentation.
There's big money in these Warren articles,
right.
And they have assessing the needs for that. I'm going to throw out, I know it's late, I'm about as tired as everybody else is here too, but we had a year where in the 11th hour, a $4.6 million bond was thrown out here for the pump station. Remember that?
Yeah.
Okay, for those that were here. And I mean really in the 11th hour, we had
Which one was that anyway? Yeah.
Nothing about it.
Church Street Pump
Station. Oh, that one, yeah.
The same year as the fire station.
And we agonized over that because on the basis of what we had done in the past, if you didn't come before us, if we didn't know anything about it, if we were shooting in the dark, excuse me, Tim, all right, we wouldn't vote to approve that.
Right.
We wouldn't vote to recommend it.
I agree with that.
If we had not voted to recommend it and everybody took our recommendations, we ran the risk of the beach overflowing.
Yeah.
All right.
It was shut down.
So that really put our backs to the wall, and some of us who ordinarily would have voted one way had to turn around and say, well, we've got to trust in this and do it that way. But I'll tell you, for those of us who sat on that committee thinking about spending $4.7 million of taxpayer money, because when you do that, I have to remind you, something else doesn't get paid for. And $4.7 million, you go years of something else is not getting paid for. That's a big trade-off. That's a big responsibility. So when we have warrant articles coming in from DPW to the tune of $5 million, and one's in this week, one's out next week, one's back in, one's revised, we don't have a clue, and you're not going to have a clue till you get the final drafts in January, mm-hmm. All right?
you should know a little bit of something about what's going on. So if you feel confident that you can do that without sending a couple of soldiers out to fact find in the meantime, and you feel confident that you can do that in one session with DPW, I'm with you. But I'm telling you that there are consequences, good and bad, of being underinformed as it pertains to the welfare of the community.
The Budget Committee will be damaged for a long time, if not irreparably, by not defending its duty as defined by law. Black letter law. No room for interpretation.
Madam Chairman, I want to say I've been waiting forever now. First of all, I was a selectman in reference to the pump station. We had the same problem. They come in and say it's liable to blow up any minute. Were you ever inside that pump station the way it was before we fixed it? It was all rusted apart. The handles were falling off and everything. Mm. When we saw that, we said, we don't have any choice. Mm. It's not up for grabs. We don't have any choice. That's looking at from a selectman.
I was in that.
I sympathize with the Budget Committee because we were in the same boat. Yeah. Now back to the problem at hand.
But you had access to go see it.
Yes.
Well, you could have too.
Back then we could have. You're right. But now here we are in another situation.
Yeah, but let me finish the point here I want to make. That gentleman knows that sewage treatment plant upside down, in and out and everything. That guy knows more about trucks. We've been through this. And for us not to take advantage of their expertise and have them go through the departments is a lousy excuse for not doing a job the way it's supposed to be done. Just because the Board of Selectmen and the town manager want to be difficult, or whatever you want to call it, that's for them. We should try to maintain our job and do it to the best of our abilities because we were elected to do that.
Right.
We are elected by the voters in Hampton. Right. To watch out for the budget. And we should look at the equipment, we should look at the trucks if we want to, and if they don't like it, it's too bad. We are doing our job as per the statute. You see that, Sandra? See that statute? Good show.
It's all everybody, an interpretation.
It's all easy to read. Right. It's not
all right. Then let everybody go home soon. Do I have a motion on the floor of what course
I seconded
that
it.
To take? What was the motion again?
Change operational procedures to services performed, or whatever it was. Let me look it up.
Services. Just take the words right out of there.
Services rendered. Services rendered. Yeah, right. Change operational to services rendered. That's okay. What you said before.
Mm-hmm. And you second it?
Yes.
All right.
Do you have what you're going to send to them?
Yeah, we already wrote it up last
time. We already did it. We're just changing the wording. If operational troubles everyone, like I said, the end result may be the same. But if operational bothered them.
So services performed is the phrase.
Services performed? Okay. Can I have a vote on that?
This was passed unanimously last. We're just changing the phrase from.
It was not passed unanimously.
No.
Oh, that's right. No Jeffrey.
Yes. You were being a
and
pain that night
being,
too.
And Selectman Bean. All right. Hands up so we can have a count because remember our secretary is remote.
3, 4, 5,
okay.
6, 7, 8, 9, 4.
All right.
Nine.
And no's? So Nick is
one,
a no.
Two,
Jim is
three,
a no.
Four.
Brian is a no. Sandy is a no, and abstentions.
9-6. 9-5.
9-4.
9-4.
9-4.
And
that's
I'm
it.
Sorry, Scott, were you for it against?
Four.
Okay. All right.
Well, there's two people missing tonight, right? We only have 13 people.
Well, Bean,
that's
right. Bean would say no, right? He
but there was somebody else missing.
Yeah, you? Dave would.
Yeah. Oh, right. Okay, thank you.
All right. You so I'll change it, and then after that, then we have no other options.
Are you ready for a motion?
I have a quick question.
Absolutely.
I'm sorry. Looking forward, okay, when we it's a $26 million budget. There's a bunch of line items in this budget. In our final review, are we going to look and say, okay, you know, we didn't really get a good answer on electricity for the police building. So are we going to say, well, take $20,000 out of that?
No.
I mean, are we?
Motion can be made and seconded, and then we're going to vote on it.
You can.
Well, I don't know that. I think, first of all, it's 420 line items. Yeah. I've counted everyone and looked at everyone.
Yeah. You're asking,
I think
you're
we
asking
are,
for a
we ought to come in with
criteria by which we make a decision, and that's really up to each individual member.
Right. What I intend to do is come in and say a statement based off the total analysis that I've done from A to Z. I think, this is what I think, based on these facts.
And adjust it accordingly.
By line item or in total? Or how?
Yes, you want the line item.
Line by line,
the whole budget again.
Right. I don't think...
It can go, it can, well, this is a review, and it's everybody involved. I mean, last year, some of us struggled, and we did a line by line by line by line, but when we came in, it was a matter of, all right, reduce the gas lines everywhere there's a gasoline line to this amount, to this percent, or by this percent. And so some of them may be grouped together. I hate to use this, but I'm going to. In the police budget, there are multiple lines for training.
Sure, yeah.
You may decide in the police budget that in a lump, this amount should be paid and let him redistribute it where he wants.
Okay,
I'm just using a for instance on how you can take multiple lines and put them together. You're not going to nickel and dime this budget and say, well, I think it should be instead of $500, $450. That's crazy.
Yeah.
You know, find the big things that you have problems with, and we will go down department by department, but as we do them, everybody should be prepared. There'll be duplications in some things, and that's where there'll be amendments. We don't have to speak for an hour on it. Just, I think it should be this.
Should go pretty fast.
One line, mm-hmm. line, it really does, because you there won't be as, there are big blaring things already.
Oh, yeah.
Okay, but you're not gonna take every single solitary line and nickel and dime it.
No.
That in reality, in all the years I've been here, that doesn't really happen. Everybody, all 15 people here might have a few things that they've keyed in on. That's where having this many people helps. Because we don't all have expertise on everything. I always defer IT to anybody but me because I have no clue. All right, some are more abreast with fire department, some are more in with the school department and understand those expenses. So that's why so many, and I'd start doing that from now, okay? That way, if you have questions, when you look at it, and now you start to look at it saying, do I want to hold this recommendation or do I have a better one? And I'll give you this, too, for guidance. You don't always have to take money out of the budget that's proposed. We've had times where we have added money.
Right. We had for two firemen 1 year.
We put four firemen right into the budget and got them.
Two.
It's
okay.
But we had years that we did that. So you may look at some lines and feel they're underfunded.
Just come in prepared, please.
Yes. All right. Motion?
Motion to adjourn.
Second.
Okay.
All in favor, say aye.
At 10:19. Thank you, everyone. Endurance.